Okay, welcome back to part two of this charmingly incompetent series of video recordings on dplyr. Okay, so we're up to filtering, and I figure I should take this moment to say that the reason I'm wearing these sunglasses is not to look cool, because I am in no way, shape, or form cool, but rather to obscure where I'm looking, because it's really, really disorienting when the speaker doesn't make proper eye contact with the camera, so here we go. Okay, so let's just tab back to where we were, very professionally, because I totally know what I'm doing, and we are up to filtering data. So where we're up to is that we have loaded the data, the small world of words data, from the CSV file, and we have renamed it so that the variable names inside the SWOW data frame are things that we would like to use. So that's a little bit user-friendly and a bit human usable. Now what we want to do is find ways of doing the specific analysis that we want to do with the data that we've got. The Small World of Words database has about 500,000 odd rows in it, and what we really want to do is find a way of picking out those rows or those parts of the data that are relevant to the question we want to do. And this is called filtering data. See, I've got a little picture of a coffee filter, and the whole idea is that what you want to do is filter it so that the stuff you want to keep makes it through your little filter. Yeah, I know. I'm not as funny as I think I am. I'm sorry. Okay, so what we're going to do is have a look at some of the ways in which the English language is gendered. That's how that's what we're going to use as our working example. So the first place to look, the first thing we want to do is to extract those cases when the Q word was woman. So in the experiment, we might have said, okay, woman, and you had to give a response, and that might have been man, but it also might have been lady, or human, or female. You get the idea. Okay, so what things do people say when prompted with the word woman? What we want to do to do that is use the filter function in dplyr. And it works like this. In a relatively straightforward way, we take the SWOW data frame and pipe it to filter, and then what we do is we pass it an expression. And the expression here is Q double equals woman. Q here appears without quote marks in it because it's the name of a variable inside SWOW. The long equals is equivalent to two equal signs. And woman, because in this case it's a piece of text inside the data set, we're putting in quotes. And then we close our parentheses so that it's a valid R statement. And out will pop some answer. Okay, so apparently we have a tibble as our response, but now there are only 26 rows and the same 6 variables. Oh, sorry, 28 rows. So there's our 28 rows, and we can see that in this case we've picked the rows that correspond to the those cases where the Q word was woman. So in each case, Q is woman, and there are possible responses that people could have given. So 38 of the 100 people that were asked replied with man when given woman as the Q, 22 of the 100 people responded with female, and so on. So that gives us our n response, n total, and the associative strength is just, as I said before, the ratio of these two things. Notice that we've kept the ID number. We won't use that for most of this module, but it'll turn out to be useful later on. So this is remembering for us that the first row in this small data frame, this filtered data frame, corresponds to row number 477,315 in the original data set. That will turn out to be helpful for us, which is why it was really useful at the beginning to create this ID variable. Okay, so what we might want to do is then, after constructing this filtering operation, we will save the resulting data to the woman FWD data set, which stands for woman forward. That's what we're going to call the forward associations from woman. And we're going to draw a plot of it. So as before, we go ggplot. This is from the data visualization module. So we would pass it the data set, which is woman. And then we're just going to create, we're going to use geomcol to plot some responses. So on our x-axis is the response variable, And on the y-axis, we're going to plot the strength variable. When we do that, we get this plot as our output. Now, this is not amazingly easy to read, so what we can do to make it a little bit easier is add the chord flip statement. And what that does is reverse the x and y axes around. There's a bit of a backstory to why I've written chord flip rather than just saying, why didn't you make y the strength variable and x the make y the response variable and x the strength variable? And the answer is that in used to be the case that in ggplot you couldn't do that. That's changed recently, so that's why my code looks the way that it is. So what you can see from looking at this is that man is by far the most common response. So about 30% of responses were man, 22% of responses were female, and it falls off quite quickly after that. So let's, in order to make sure that we are keeping up in our script, I will now tab over to the RStudio Cloud project and I will do this myself. So we'll kind of go filter the data. Always remember to write your comments in. So we're going to go woman, FWD is swell, and what we're going to do is then go pipe it to, and she remembers that she's got another keyboard here that she can use so her fingers don't get in the way of things. Very good at this. Filter. Of course, the only problem is that I'm not familiar with this keyboard. Filter. So we go, the Q variable is woman. Okay. And we could save that and we could source it as is. And we've got a mistake. This is one that you will encounter a lot because everybody makes this mistake. What I've done wrong here is that I've only entered one equal sign. What I should have done is entered two equal sign. You can see that that is such a common error that the error message actually gives you a hint that says, hey, maybe you should have been using double equals. The way to remember is that the double equals is a test. So it's a test to see if Q equals woman. If you want to try and assign the Q to woman, then you would use a single equals. So that's the thing that's going on there. Let's clear that so that we'll pretend I never made that error. And I totally did that on purpose. Okay, so now we will source my script and it does something that makes sense. So you can see over here in the environment pane, it's showing woman FWD as a data set. So I will go over here to the console, make sure that it was doing what I said it was, woman FWD, and it takes a second to send me things over the internet, and that's the data that we've got. Okay, so we have here woman, man, woman, female. Yep, that's what we had before. Okay, I'm not going to add the plots to my script because the plots are really there just to help you, the audience, know what's going on. But we'll do it here at the console just to make things a little clearer. So we'll go ggplot woman FWD plus geom col. That's short for columns, and then we're going to set up our mapping equals. So it's in a, we need to do the aesthetics. So we'll go x equals strength. So x equals the response. So that is what did people give as a response to that keyword. And then for y, we're going to pick the strength variable. So that's the measure of associative strength between these two words. So that, when I do it, gives us the ugly plot, with which has everything we want, but the axis labels are impossible to read. So what you saw me do in the slides was this. I added a chord flip statement, and the output then just flips the x and y coordinates around, and now you've got something that you can see. I'm about to test whether or not I have the correct version, or the most recent version of ggplot on this, because what I should be able to do is reverse things like so, and it doesn't work. What this is telling me is that I don't have the most recent version of ggplot. Okay, so luckily we will go back to the way things were, and here is our data. Okay, cool. So we have something that is telling us something about the relationship between man and woman in this data set. What's annoying though is a lot of those responses are a bit idiosyncratic, right? So if only one person has given a particular response, it may not be super useful to keep it in the data. So we have here Joy, her, yeah, those are reasonable responses. I'm not so sure about great. I'm definitely not so sure about shapely. Birth is a bit of a weird one in there. Maybe what we should do for the sake of robustness is only look at those responses that at least two people gave. That at least has some degree of reassurance that we're picking out meaningful aspects of the data. So to do this, let's go back to the slides, which tell us something about how to do that. One way of doing it is just simply to add another filter statement. So we could go, we take the output of our first statement and then we pipe it to another filter operation. So we took the data, we piped it to filter, and we selected those cases where Q is equal to woman. We could then pipe the results of that as another step in the chain to filter only those responses that were given by more than one person. So that's n response greater than one. And we can plot the data again, and this gives us those responses that were produced by at least two people. So wife, strong, me, man, lady, girl, female, beauty. So that's one way we could do it. And I will first, before doing anything else, go back over to my script and show you that. Oops. There we go. So I will just continue the filtering command that I did before. So we pipe it to filter again. Filetto, that is totally a good command. Why don't we go filter? Yay! Filter in responses. Response greater than one. Okay, so I save that, I source that, and if we go up here, control L to clear my screen, and then we go have a look at what we've got. We have woman forward. Okay, so these are the eight responses that were most common, were given by at least two people, and we can feel like these are reasonably sensible associations between woman and other words. Okay, so that is one way of doing it. There are other ways in which this can be done. The filter function is surprisingly flexible, and if she remembers how to tab back, yay! I'm really rocking this. I know. I'm so sorry. Okay, the other way of doing it is that the filter function allows you to pass multiple expressions. So in order to be retained in the data, so to make it through the filter, each row has to satisfy all of the criteria or all of the expressions that you list inside your filter statement. So a simpler way of doing the exact same thing is just to separate each expression that you want in a single filter command. So if I go back to my script, we go back over here, I didn't actually need to do this as two separate filter statements. What I could have done is just this. So we'll delete that, I'll put a comment in there, and now that's going to do precisely the same thing. It's going to filter by Q equals woman and n response greater than one. So we'll just highlight these rows, Control Enter to run just those rows. Let's check after we've run that that we get the same answer. Woman forward is same thing. So you can see that if you include multiple expressions in your filter statement, we get the same thing as if you had filtered multiple times. And that's kind of a handy little way to construct filtering operations. And you can tell that I know what I'm doing, which is why I'm going back and forward. What I actually wanted to do was Alt-Tab, or back to this. Okay, so here we go. At this point, you have an opportunity to do this by yourself. So open exercise, dplyr, part two, and then the script here should lead you through another exercise where you go and create the woman sub back for backwards associates. Backwards associates, just to give you the psychological explanation of the background, is are things where, what are the words that produce woman as a response? So if I said lady as the Q word, there's a chance that you might say woman as your response. And those are the cases that we want to find using this. So forward associations are when the Q is woman, and backwards association is when the response is woman. These two different types of associations carry a little bit of different information about the structure of language in the lexicon. So we're going to do the same thing. This is what I'm going to ask you to do on your own, is to create the woman BCK variable, and you want to select cases where woman is the response, and only keep those cases where there are at least two responses. Once we've done that, we're going to go on to the next section, which is going to be how to arrange our data.